Hey friends, many companies need to plan multiple routes each day for their mobile workers. Using Azure Maps, they can use matrix routing to optimize which stops to assign to each worker and how to combine multiple routes into a single batch request. Julie is here to show us how that works today on Azure Friday. Hey folks, I'm Scott Hanselman, and it's another episode of Azure Friday. I'm here with Julie Kohler, and we're going to talk about matrix routing in maps. That sounds complicated. Matrix, I think I took a math class on that. I'm a little intimidated already.
Don't be intimidated. It's much simpler the way we've implemented it, so okay. Don't worry.
So there's math involved, but I don't have to think about it as a developer.
Exactly.
Okay. So how does Azure Maps use this batch routing and matrix routing, and why do I care?
Yeah, so there's a couple of things. So these are the new things that we've added to routing. So we've talked a little bit about some of our routing features in previous episodes. Mm-hmm. But today, talking about batch and matrix, these are some additional features we've added that really enhance the routing experience. Mm-hmm. So starting with matrix, the thing that you would want to do here is if you have a bunch of origins and destinations and you want to know the best route to get from point A to point B or point A to point C, mm-hmm. we can give you a matrix that gives those results the shortest distance, the shortest travel time, and you can decide which one to take based on the matrix of results. This matrix will actually allow you to pass in a number of values to get up to a number of 700 cells. And so if you had 10 origins, 70 destinations, you could do that. Or if you had different numbers, it doesn't have to be perfect. But as long as you can get up to 700 different cells in that matrix that you're building.
And the matrix is on the way, the matrix I'm building is on the way in, and then I get back multiple routes on the way back?
So you would have your origins on one side of the matrix and your destinations on the other, mm-hmm. and then that's what builds that matrix for you.
Okay. Did your machine fall asleep there?
It did. Okay. So let me do a quick matrix routing call to show an example. So this is in Postman.
Okay.
So what I've done here is I've got my subscription key, which I will change after these videos, mm-hmm. and then let me show you the body here. So I've got my coordinates, so multi-point coordinates, and I've got my origins, and I've got my destinations, mm-hmm. and then it's going to build a matrix for me and tell me the different distances and times to travel between these sets of points.
Okay.
So let me send this.
And this is using that atlas.microsoft.com, that's that Azure Maps endpoint for all of our API calls mm-hmm. that we've seen again in previous episodes, and you can go and check out those episodes to learn more of the basics on how to do these kind of calls.
Yes. So let's see the results here. All right, so I've got information about this matrix, so mm-hmm. I can see the length in meters, the travel time in seconds, I can see departure time, arrival time, all of that comes back for each set of origins and destinations that you passed into this matrix.
Hmm. So I could do this potentially for like dozens or hundreds of vehicles all at once in one call?
You could. A common scenario for this is something like somebody who has a bunch of distribution centers. Mm-hmm. And so maybe if you have distribution centers, you would feed those in as your origins.
Okay.
And then you have a bunch of deliveries you need to make for the day. That could be your destinations. And so you would figure out from which distribution center should those deliveries be made, and you would know which one would have the shortest route and which one to deliver to based on that information from the matrix.
So this can be anyone who's doing any kind of fleet-based routing, whether it be package delivery or people that are going and doing local sales calls or
yeah,
whatever.
Exactly. Finding the optimal route for a bunch of destinations and origins.
Do most people who do that kind of work like just have their employees in the car with like a map app on their phone kind of doing that?
Sometimes that happens. Sometimes there's a center where they figure out all the routes and tell you at the beginning of the day where you're going to go. But it could be changed throughout the day as well.
But if you have a small company like that, maybe you have people like just figuring it out on the phone, they're probably just doing these things one at a time, one
yeah.
location, one destination, almost guaranteed they're not doing it the most effective
yes.
and efficient way.
This is how to do it optimally. Mm-hmm. So this is what the matrix will help you figure out at the beginning of the day.
And people who have Azure accounts and people who watch Azure Friday, you have access to the Azure Maps right now.
Like yes.
I can set up one of the accounts immediately.
Yes, it's very easy to set up.
And I can see that you're doing a regular call in Postman with REST with your subscription key. So you've hidden all the complexities from me. All I need to understand is Latin lawn, my frums and my twos, and I can go and set this up.
Yep, very simple to get set up.
Then go ahead.
Moving on to batch routing. So mm-hmm. let me explain the use cases for this one. So batch routing allows you to pass a number of calls for different routes that you need to make. Maybe a similar situation. At the beginning of a day, you have a number of deliveries you need to make. You know exactly where they are.
Right.
And you want to come up with all of the routes for the day. Or you have a fleet of trucks, and you want to come up with the routes for all 100 trucks for that day, and you can do that in a batch now. Mm. Previously, you had to call one by one and make those individual calls, but now you can just make one single call with all of those requests in it and get all of the routes for the day. Mm. We actually support up to 1,000 calls for batch routing. It will take a little bit of time depending on the number that you pass in. So if you pass in 1,000, it will take a little bit of time to calculate. But that process is running in the background, and so you can still make other calls. If you want to do a matrix call while you're doing a batch, that's fine. It won't interfere. And so it really frees up the process and lets you make that call, wait for the results, and then come back later
and find your routes. So we're basically letting the parallelism of Azure do that work, and Azure Maps spins off its multiple threads and worries about that stuff. And
exactly. Then lets me know when it's done. You don't have to worry about it. We take care of it. And you can run multiple things at a time while you wait for the results of that call.
So you said if I did 1,000, it might be a problem. But if I felt like doing multiple 100 batches or whatever works for my particular application, I could do that.
Yeah, and those will come back faster if you do less of them. Mm-hmm. So I'll show a simple one here. And this one may come back pretty fast. But again, I have my subscription key. And then if you look at the body, I've passed three simple queries, so I'm going to get three routes back from this one.
Oh, and before you do that, this is really interesting because you've expressed them in a way that I understand because I've used this API before. You passed in multiple query strings as if you were doing multiple gets, except you took the query string and put it into the body, and you posted those query strings three times.
Yeah.
That feels very intuitive to me as someone who likes doing work in Postman.
Yeah, and you can adjust the parameters as well. So if you notice for the first one, I said, I want the fastest route and I want travel mode car. For the second one, I said, I don't worry about traffic. And so you have the option of being really specific about what you want for those routes as well. It can be very customizable.
Yeah, I've seen map applications where they'll default to one, like the quickest way, but then they have a routes button and I can go and say eco-friendly, least traffic, whatever, avoid toll roads. I can give that kind of an experience to my fleet now.
Exactly. And if each one's different, you can pass the different parameters for each query. Mm-hmm. So if a truck has hazardous materials and you need to know that, that's something you could pass here as well.
And Azure Maps supports that level of stuff. It's not just fastest and shortest.
Yeah.
It's constraints, roads to stay off of, tolls to avoid, could you do truck height even?
Yes, we do truck height as well. So we have a lot of parameters that you can pass in a very complex routing system.
That's cool. Yeah. I mean, I'm already thinking about what I could potentially write with this.
Yeah.
And I was literally moving really, really slowly in a parking garage yesterday because I didn't know if my car was 6'5 or 6'6.
Yeah.
I would have liked to have known ahead of time.
It's a tricky situation.
It's a little scary.
That one
turns out
test.
I was okay.
Okay.
Okay, so am I going to get all the responses back in the result?
So I'll send this one. And let's
travel
take
mode
a look.
Bicycle eco. I'm interested in how the bicycle is going to be. I guess it's eco-friendly by its existing. So it said accepted.
Yep.
So you have a 202, and that's done as a batch. So then you go to the location it gives you to retrieve the batch.
Yes. Yeah, so in the header, you'll get the location back. If it returns very quickly, you might get the result back immediately. But a 202 means that it's running, and you can check it in a few seconds.
And we should talk about that just very, very briefly, if you don't mind. So when you do an HTTP call, you get back a 200, that's like, okay.
Yep, okay, there's your results, you're good.
Right.
202 means we're working on it, it was good, it was successful, but you're gonna need to make one more call to get those results back.
And that's nice because you don't wanna have to write code that just blocks and waits for 2 seconds, 3 seconds.
Yeah.
Let your app be very responsive.
Yeah, so you take that URL from the previous result, I'm just gonna copy that in here and do the get.
Cool. Now, I assume if it wasn't ready, it would tell me something about not yet, come back in a minute.
You'll get a status code that says it's still working on it.
Okay, cool.
But we are done here, and so I got my successful response back. I see my number of requests was 3, and it has given me my route for every single request that I've asked for.
And this gives such flexibility. I mean, you could imagine overlaying that on a map in different colors or different information to tell the person how they could pick it.
Yeah.
All the kind of stuff that we see that we find so impressive in the map applications that we use, we can integrate into our applications today.
Yeah, very easily.
How is it billed on a per call basis? If I do 1,000 calls in a batch, it's the same as if I called them separately.
It's based on transactions, so it's basically like you made 1,000 calls, 1,000 queries.
So this is just gonna make my existing applications all the better.
Yep.
Fantastic. Is this available now?
This is available now. It's currently in preview mode, but soon it will be available generally.
Very cool. So where can people go and learn about Azure Maps?
Yep. Go to our website. We have a bunch of documentation up. You can look at, and I don't know the exact URL.
That's okay. I'm sure you can go out there and search for Azure Maps, but you'll find samples and sample code.
Yes.
And you can go and sign up, get your own subscription key, and make this happen today.
Yeah.
Fantastic. I am learning all about matrix routing and batch calls into Azure Maps today on Azure Friday.